Neal Adams seems to be one kind of guy, full of self-confidence and with a big ego. Based on his amazing ability to craft gorgeous-looking comics. So it seems more than fitting to celebrate his art of sequential storytelling with this huge omnibus, more than 1,000 pages thick and pretty well made. Especially, I like that they don't use the usual black cardboard covers. And it's pretty well made. The binding opens very good, and it has already survived one read-through from cover to cover without big damage. Everything's seems fine to me, and I haven't read it lying flat on the table. I held it always upright, so it was pretty a stress test for this book here. So now to the contents. Yeah, that's unfortunate that they mention the colorists, the recolorists, just here, but you can't guess or figure out who recolored which issue. That would have been nice if they would have gone this extra inch to mention which colorist did the recoloring here, because somehow, especially for the Neal Adams aficionados amongst you, this has been a big issue. Some like the coloring, but as I guess, even more hate the coloring, the recoloring. I'm somehow in the middle. I'm not that emotional when it comes to Neal Adams comics. I like this book fair enough. So, it consists out of three parts, as you can see. The biggest part here and the most important part are his Batman and Brave and the Bold and Detective Comics, most of them written by Danny O'Neill, but there are lots of other writers. Let's see, Bob Haney did a lot. Neal Adams wrote some on his own. And Frank Robbins, Len Wein, and so on and so on. Then here's the second part. That's the Odyssey. And the third part is original art covers and so on. To show you some of my favorites, among them, sure, there are these Brave and the Bold Batman and Deadman stories, which make, as I think, great use of the character Deadman. In one and done story where his abilities and so on came into full fruition. He possesses people and switches between them, and that's always a bit scary. And here you can see, one of the reasons why I have some problems with the new coloring as well, because the faces and these airbrushy effects don't look too good always. Sometimes I don't have too much problems with them, but I will give a comparison between the old look and the new look at the end of the video. And here we have another favorite of mine, Batman and Sergeant Rock. Again, Brave and the Bold. It's number 84 from 1969, and that's pretty amazing, if, especially if you think about the time when it came out. How the cape here is used to structure the page. In terms of the story, this is not too gorgeous or something like that, because in on 24 pages, Batman and Sergeant Rock and his crew has to save Winston Churchill's ass, and therefore they have to rely on many accidents and random events. So they have a lot of luck, and it's not very believable. But hey, it's very entertaining, and who wants historical accuracy or something like that? Maybe don't take a Batman comic for it. Read some other books. And there's another thread that goes through Neal Adams' Batman comics, I guess, and this is the total absence of scientific accuracy. Okay, this is Man-Bat, of course, Professor Langström, aka Professor Langström. And of course, it's not possible that a human being can morph into an animal character and back again. Not possible in any sense, of course. But on the second, in which annoys me more, on a second thought, are these hands. Bats don't have hands. They just have long fingers, and the flying skin is spread between these fingers. And so the depiction of the man bat is at least questionable. And even though the story around the man bat and the lady man bat, who is so in love with Langström that she is turned or has turned into a bat being as well, that's pretty touching. And yeah, I don't think this is a mean pink recoloring. Another favorite of mine, and I guess of many people, is Batman number 251. Well, the Joker, where Joker kills off his old buddies, and Batman helps the ex-henchman of Joker. The coloring of the face here is a bit off, really. And it ends with this extremely cool fight of Batman in a water tank with this shark. He breaks his neck with a chain, and then he breaks the water tank. And so, overall, on the bottom line, if you can cope with questionable coloring like that, you get a good amount of very important comics from Neal Adams. The Batman history would be a lot poorer if these comics, iconic comics, would never have been drawn. There's a lot of Ra's al Ghul in it, and Batman and Robin stories, and these Brave and Bo the Bold comics are probably my favorite. And his panel structuring, I spoke about already. Yeah, pretty essential stuff in one book. and a joy to read and to look at. So Neal Adams has proven again and again that he's able to tell a story in pictures. So it's a pretty surprise to see, or to read his Odyssey, a long epic, which is really a brilliantly drawn, gorgeously demented mess of a story. Despite of all the perfect ingredients, like, let's see if I can find them, dinosaurs, the Joker, Dead Man, a superhero that stems from Neanderthals, and one superhero that is actually a reptile. And again, gorgeous looking art, here you can see. But the story overall is just not good, to put it mildly. It's so bad that it's already maybe good. And yeah, Neal Adams has always to put on many explanations. Here's Bruce Wayne, half naked on the beginning of every story, and he tells the story in the text, and the speech bubbles in superfluous dialogue between all his characters and in expositional texts, and no character is really in character. They are all off a lot. It's almost like a Batman story in Mad Magazine, where they would have exaggerated everything to the extreme and so to make fun of it. But Neal Adams, I don't get him as a very a guy whose greatest strength is irony. It's really a compendium how to don't write a comic story. Yeah, therefore pretty amazing as well. On top of it, Neal Adams is a fan of the hollow earth theory. You know that our earth is hollow within, has spaces where these creatures and other could roam. And all the continent moving theory, which is actually fact, because it's proven 1,000 times. But that's crap, according to Neal Adams. Our Earth is growing bigger and bigger, and therefore there have to be these spaces in the Earth, as I said already. If you don't believe me that Neal Adams believes this hollow crap, hollow earth crap bullshit, go on his YouTube channel. There you can see a movie or a documentary about this idea of a growing earth. Yeah. Neal Adams is one kind of guy, as I said it in my introduction to this video. The last part of this Neal Adams omnibus is a collection of his Batman-related covers. And I think for lots of you, this is alone reason enough to buy this omnibus. If you're not into this kind of coloring and too allergic to this stuff, even though I think Neal Adams likes his pink, real pink, and his green, real green, and everything bigger than life and more colorful than ever. But if you don't like this coloring, maybe you have to buy the Bronze Age Batman omnibus. But when I see the original art from Neal Adams like this here, he likes his Batman pretty colorful and with pinks and violets and greens and whatnot all over. Not necessarily in digital coloring, of course. But somehow I always get the impression of Neal Adams as an artist who, if he can choose, do I miss an effect or put I in another effect on the another effect, he will always go for maximum input, maximum output, maximum effect, maximum layers, layer upon layer of art, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but it's the Neal Adams approach to do Batman comics. Very, that's my shortcut to Neal Adams art. You don't have to agree, of course. Now for a closer look at the recoloring in comparison to the older coloring, the original coloring. This is the digital from the omnibus. As you can see here, very colorful, but actually Brave and the Bold number 80, but actually the original one from the issues wasn't too cautious neither, so you, if you take a closer look, you can see the differences on the cover, but it's not so spectacular. Here we have some more differences, especially the new coloring always wants to give us a detailed impression of all the muscles, and that's a part where I think they should be a bit more discreet, and not everything has to underline in this version, and especially in the faces, as I told you before. And here some color changes happened. Of course, you can see here that's the new version, and on the older it's blue version, and but actually I like the new version a bit more here. And on the opposite side we have the older coloring with the white face, and that's nothing to say against to change that, the color of the here. It makes actually more sense, even though again all these airbrushy effects. Colorists must respect the limits of their craft, I think. They don't, they should not try to achieve a new drawing on the old drawing. They're just colorists. And here, I hope you can see it down below. Yeah, this new coloring makes sense, I think. And to leave the face not white, it's a good decision as well. Take a look on the right hand side. This is the original coloring, especially maybe look at the face right in the right upper corner. That's the new version. Older version with the green, which I like better than this one. And there are some colors added, especially here. And if you turn the page, This page was white before in all the corners, and now they have given it a light blue background. They changed actually the font of the crack. Maybe it was too small for them. Now it's really big. And here's another page from the same Brave and the Bold, in the new coloring on the left and in the old coloring on the right. And I think overall, the new coloring has won with some of the decisions for the new coloring. Some colors are added, some things weren't even colored, like the arms here. And yeah, again, we can discuss if the cape from Batman and his costume has to have all these light effects on him, but on it. But yeah, maybe it's a matter of taste. I would prefer, again, if they have sometimes if they have left it with flat colors and not so many variations in the colors, because it takes our it takes away from the art from Neal Adams. But on the other way around, it looks, this stuff here looks pretty amazing. So this is a scan of Brave and the Bold number 93, a crossover between Batman and the House of Mystery. And what strikes me is, if you look close at Batman's cape, for an example, it has a very, color-wise, it has a very modern feel to it, almost like it is already colored with a computer, which is obviously not the case. So it's not that a surprise that the new recolored version the color doesn't look too different. The colors are more vibrant and all, but basically it's similar, even though these old effects here in the background, I wish they would have stuck to it and didn't change it just for the sake of changing it. So obviously I can understand the hate that the new recoloring gets from a lot of people. For an instance, when James Gordon's face is computerized in this fashion here, in comparison to the more flat colors in the original one. But on the other way around, I think there are lots of panels who really have who really look yeah, maybe a bit more interesting now, more colorful, so to speak, than before. Maybe, or very probably, it's the ignorance speaking, because Neal Adams wasn't never my favorite Batman artist, and this omnibus hasn't changed this. But I think somehow the new coloring, these explosion of colors on some pages, really fits what Neal Adams always wants to achieve, pulling all the stops, doing these comics who are bigger than life, which are bigger than life. And if you have some effects, yeah, do it onto the page right now. He is not the most sublime Batman artist, and so I think he would have stopped it if he wouldn't have liked the new coloring At least he did the introduction for it. So I think he agreed on the new treatment for the Batman omnibus. And somehow that's all I need to know, because he's the artist. He has to decide. But on the other way, sure, there are some reasons why these collections should use the original coloring, of course. So, yeah. That was my take on the Neal Adams Omnibus. Better later than never. So, thanks for watching and listening. Goodbye.